don't believe him. I like Lauro, don't get me wrong, he's like a brother. But to be honest, he drinks a little more than he should. The itch for a drink gets us all, but to him more than others, and when you drink too much, the imagination wanders. Here, yesterday, it was me who tied one over, and I thought I heard Jonas's voice by the canal. I called back to him, as you guessed, but then nothing. Drink. It blurs the senses.
What if he's dead?
What do you think about Captain Vasco?
He's a damn good navigator, and an excellent leader of men. He knows his craft well, in spite of being so young.
How old is he?
He's not seen his 25th year yet. If he keeps it up, he'll be an admiral one day.
Nice.
I need to be going. Farewell.
Fourth quarter. Let's see. What do you have going on over here? Lauro, how you doing, my guy?
I've been told that you know the missing cabin boy well. Is that right?
You talking about Jonas? You bet your stars I know him. But like I've been crying to the nine deaf winds, he didn't go missing, he was taken.
Were you a witness to the event?
Yes, I was. Even though I'd had a few tumblers in the belly, I hadn't yet lost my head. The other day, in the tavern, I saw him talking to a well-dressed man. Surrounded by some other sly ruffians. And then when we left, him and I, Flavia left a little earlier, you understand. Well, those brutes were there, waiting for him. They just up and took him like that. Grabbed his arms and poof. Gone. Vanished.
Why didn't you intervene?
I tried to, believe me. But my legs betrayed me. Wavering they were. And I fell into the gutter.
Did you report this to the captain?
Unfortunately not. I know all too well what weight my words carry. Even Flavia treated me like a drunken fool. And the captain? No, not telling him that. I still have some pride left, you get me?
Did Jonas seem troubled, a mere cabin boy?
How would I know? Jonas is a gentle boy who keeps his head down. You think my story is nothing but mist too, don't you?
It's just that I can't imagine a gang of thugs hoping to get a ransom for a cabin boy. Did anyone else see the kidnapping?
There was still a small crowd in the tavern.
Stream died for a second. Are we back? Are we good? Regular being there. I hope we're back and good.
Play cards with him from time to time. The kind of fellow who plays from morning to nighttime to be that skilled. But now and again he comes out. When nature calls, you know. I kind of remember his face being there.
Thank you, Lauro.
I missed it. I was trying to make sure that I didn't lose the entirety of my stream. That would have been bad. Let's see.
I can feel it. We need to lift the veil on this.
So, find and interrogate the witness. Tell the captain that we're ready to raise anchor, which I am not. Prepare a drink laced with sleeping pills. No. A prison interior smuggle. Okay. There's no way to like jump, and it actually is making me very, very disappointed. Get out of my way! I will fight you. I will put a dagger in the back of your head. All right, let's talk to this guy, see what's up.
I'm happy to see you. Your absence this morning worried both your father and me.
Come now, Sir de Corsillon. My father may have been angry, outraged, or disappointed, but he's never worried about me. I'm sad to have caused you any worry, though. Would you believe that I was rotting away in a sinister jail, guarded by thugs ready to kill me? Though still seeing double from last night's drink, I was preparing an ingenious escape plan when, ta-da, my fair cousin jumped up out of nowhere and saved me. I'm quite the fairy tale damsel in distress.
You might have refrained from the company of bandits the night before such an important departure.
Take away the risk and halve the pleasure, de Corsillon. It is the salt of life.
I fear that some of my teachings have been misunderstood. But you wanted to ask me something, de Sade?
What will be your official title on Tirfredi? Or are you just here to keep an eye on us?
Come now, don't be ridiculous. I'm coming in the capacity of official advisor, nothing more. But His Highness has also asked me to report to him on certain strategic observations. I am therefore required to take note of all events, chart the island and its resources, but also obtain as much knowledge as possible concerning the more dangerous creatures of the island. Your help will be extremely valuable to me. I've no longer the legs of an adventurer.
It's always a privilege to help, Master. I need to be leaving. I have quite a few things to do before we raise anchor.
Yes, correct. Such as fucking picking up my goddamn skill. Jesus Christ.
I've already been to the port authorities. They keep the official documents upstairs.
Yikes. This is gonna go bad. Ah, shit!
To my help! And death to the others!
Oh, damn. All right. Cool. We've now leveled up. To do absolutely nothing. God damn it. I still need to make level 4, dude. Oh, this is upsetting. Very, very upsetting, dude. Dude, it's... Give me the gold, give me this. Sailor's coat? Oh shit, yes. Yes. Okay. Kurt, up the stairs! Coins, okay. So let me see, now that I've got the sailor's coat, which actually looks super nice, maybe I can get, but just walk past people? Probably not. There's a door there. Go check out this door super quick. Can't open. Interesting. This is also a lockpicking? No, it's just loot. Okay. Sailor's boots. Sailor's gloves. Ooh. -2 on my elemental resistance. Plus, yeah, it's... You guys know what I'm talking about. I'll take that. Coins. I'll take that as well. Hopefully I can find another sailor's coat and potentially give everyone... Oops. Hopefully I can give everybody in my charge sailor's coat. The hell? No. Pigs. I want to put those on, please. We'll keep the blacksmiths on for... Surprised nobody actually heard that. What the fuck is going on here? Worn guard doublet. Ah, yes. Pick up.
Here is the ship's manifest. We only need to add our merchandise to the list.
Okay, let me see. What did I pick up? That's the blue soldier. Blue silver. Guard. We'll hold on to the sailor's coat. Okay. Interrogate the smuggler about the heretics. Be down? What I'm seeing here? Interrogate the smuggler about the heretics. Second in command. Curious is
sure.
Didn't even realize he was dead in the corner. Somebody killed him. Okay, let's see. There are warehouse guards. Over here. Search the smuggler's belongings. Find and interrogate the witness. Shit. Okay. I'm just gonna go search the belongings super quick, see what we can find over there. Resuscitation powder. That's an interesting one. I think I primarily looted the hell out of this entire area. At some point, we need to move on to the next place, but now I think we're just here to... Oh, here we go. I have two new clients. They want to go to Al-Sad, and the Inquisitors are on their heels, which will not make my job any easier. I think I can get them onto a ship inconspicuously, but we will have to be cautious, and I hope they will... prove patient and discreet. I will hide them away in a warehouse behind the harbor office where the Inquisitors will never dare to enter. I'll locate the heretics inside the... Oh, I have disguised myself as a Naut. Awesome. Coat does nothing for my hips.
Hello? What can I do for you?
We're your replacements. You're dismissed.
Finally! We were starting to grow moss. Courage, me hearties. The path is clear. We should notify the men. They need all the time they can get.
Inform the porters. Well, don't know why I say it like that. I'm starting to pick up the local language, I suppose. Aye. We'll inform the porters in just a second. Just need to talk to these two, apparently.
Who is there?
May the Illuminated save us. Did the smuggler send you? The man to which you are referring was arrested and thrown into prison. But reveal to me your hiding place.
Oh, the traitor!
Have you come to deliver us to the Inquisition, then?
Please, please, have pity on our souls. We have committed no crime. We are not heretics. We are nothing more than historians.
In that case, why is the ambassador of Teleme so concerned about your teachings? Why is the Inquisition looking for you, and why are you hiding?
Our only error was wanting to publish our work.
It's true. We presented our research, but it didn't please the censor. And here you have the result.
We fled all the way to Serene, thinking we would be safe. But the Inquisition wants to silence us so badly that they followed us here.
Alrighty then.
Tell me more about your research. What about it is so horrifying that it will provoke such a fuss?
Be right back, ladies and gentlemen.
The teachings of St. Lucius.
The disciple of St. Matthias. The one who returned to Teleme after traveling with his master.
The very same. His writing was carefully preserved, but never seriously studied.
With the discovery of Teofredi, we thought it crucial to take a look at the original text. We wanted to verify if this island could have been the faraway place that he spoke of. The Eden of St. Matthias.
And? What did you find?
Teofredi is without any doubt the land that our St. Matthias and his disciples went to. But the text that we discovered was radically different from what we expected to find.
In the original text, St. Lucius doesn't speak of an Eden, of the paradise of the illuminated. He speaks of a voice that came from the depths of the earth, which convinced St. Matthias to stay there.
It was written in black and white, and there is no doubt about it. The original was written in Lucius's own hand.
I understand now what that text has cost you. This voice from the depths sounds more the power of a demon than a saint.
The sacred texts are always difficult to interpret, but what is written is written.
Who were you hoping would give you asylum?
We were hoping to reach Al-Sad. The Inquisition won't chase us into the den of their enemies.
Our research won't interest the Bridge Alliance, or at least I doubt it. But at least we'll be safe.
By entering Al-Sad as clandestines, you risk being taken for spies.
That would be better than being burned at the stake.
Did you try speaking with the censors? You could. Forget what you have discovered, perhaps?
Oh, we have signed already an abjugation stating that we misunderstood the sacred texts of St. Lucius. We were even ready to say that we had never seen the true text, or anything else that would have pleased them.
It served no purpose. It's our lives they are after.
I see. Well, you have no other choice but to run and seek refuge in enemy territories.
I beg of you, please do not deliver us to them. Let us continue on this path.
This path is definitely not the best and righteous one. However, this path is definitely not the best and righteous one. However, definitely doesn't seem like they're going to get very far anywhere else in life, so.
I could have a word with the good Dr. Sahin, the ambassador of the Bridge Alliance. If he can be persuaded to offer you asylum, you would be saved.
Your goodness honors you. May the Illuminated forever light your path.
If I manage to convince the ambassador, you'll need to refrain from that sort of blessing. Stay here. I'll be back.
All right. Now we got a couple things we got to do real quick. We got to, first and foremost, go and notify some people about the porters. That's what it is. We got to inform the porters about the stuff that they can bring in our supplies. Super easy. Shouldn't be too hard. Oh, excuse me.
Captain, milady, we were given orders to wait here with the merchandise.
The way is clear. It's time to get going.
Do your best to be quick and quiet about it. You won't have much time to move at all.
Don't you be worrying now. We're off.
The warehouse is at the end to the right there. You can't miss it.
Move out. Quick steps.
Alrighty then. Yeah, I didn't have the time to prepare it. But now that I've got the boots and all that, hey, I'll be fine. Hopefully. Let's see. Let's go talk to the person that we think is a part of this thing that's going on here. Speak to this guy.
Tavern keeper.
I'll see you.
I am looking for a Naut. A young cabin boy who has been missing roll call for 2 days now.
A Naut, you say? That's not a lot to go on. There are quite a few that come to my tavern.
According to one of his fellows, he would have been taken right here.
A kidnapping? In my establishment? You surely jest. At least I hope you do. I would have noticed. That doesn't hold water.
Someone told me about one of your faithful clients. A big gambler, it would seem.
I see. An able-bodied man. Passes his time lightening the pouches of sailors coming through.
Where might I find him at this time?
Here? He would never give away his chair at his table. Anything else?
Nah, I think that's it.
I need to be off. Farewell.
Goodbye.
Who are you? I don't recognize you. Am I in your debt?
No, have no fear about that. It's for a different reason that I'm here. I'm looking for a Naut that disappeared 2 days ago, after visiting this establishment. A young cabin boy. Two members of his crew accompanied him.
Yes, that does ring a bell. I've played with the three of them.
What can you tell me about the boy? How was he that night?
He seemed rather nervous, as if he was worried about something. Didn't feel like playing, that I remember. And he must have been right to be nervous, if he's disappeared.
Tell me what happened that evening.
A rich merchant came in, with a band of strong arms. The kind of men you can round up for a few coins, if you catch my drift. They exchanged words with the cabin boy. The kid was defensive, not sitting pretty. And then they finally left.
And after that?
It just so happens that I did go out for a breather. I needed some fresh air. And I think I might well have seen those same men grab him. But that was none of my business. I wouldn't have thought that they were kidnapping him, if that's what it was. They weren't particularly rough with him.
Who was the rich merchant, do you think? A jilted lover? A moneylender?
No, my lady. You're in luck. It so happens that I know the man. It was Sir Fontaine, that merchant.
Where can I find him? Where can I find him?
He has a house in the wealthy boroughs, just off the canal. A stone's throw from the Ptolemy Embassy.
Thank you. You've been immensely helpful.
This man is completely owned by his love for the game. Do you think we can trust him?
What would he gain from lying?
I have no idea. But what would any wealthy merchant gain from holding a penniless child?
This is a great question. Why was this guy captured? No reason for it. Just, yeah, no. Let's go talk to this guy. See if we can't help out these historians. Hello.
Your Excellency.
Lady de Sade.
I would like to talk to you about a rather delicate matter.
I am listening.
A couple of historians have made a recent discovery concerning Mateus, the founder of the mythical Ptolemy. And it seems that this is not to the liking of the Illuminated. Or at least his more fervent subjects.
These sinister hypocrites are going to want to burn them at the stake.
Without a doubt. And that's why these poor people are begging you to offer them asylum.
We are willing. Where are they to be found at this time?
At the port of Serene. They were hoping to stow away discreetly on a vessel to Al-Sad.
Very well. I shall send an escort immediately to take them somewhere safe.
Well, that was quick.
I need to be going. Goodbye, Excellency.
Goodbye.
We owe you our lives. We are eternally grateful.
It was nothing. I hope you won't have too much difficulty adapting to your new country.
If you would allow me, I would like to give you this. It's not much, but it is all that we possess.
80 gold. Yeah, that's not bad.
You have a kind heart, Greenblood. It'll be the end of you, but that doesn't bother me. I wouldn't have wanted those poor buggers to end up on a burning pyre.
It would seem that I'm not the only one with a tender heart.
Alright. Let's see. What was our next thing? Inform the Teleme ambassador. What? I really don't want to do that right now. Can we not just say we did? It looks like this is pretty much the end of this area once we complete these last two things. Honestly, there was a lot of problem solving that I was not prepared for.
Might I help you, my lady?
I would like to have a word with Sir Fontaine.
He is absent, but the lady of the house could certainly receive you. Enter, please.
Is the lady up here? Fontaine family? Hello there.
Oh, I know you. I've seen you at court. You are Lady de Sade. And to what do I owe the honor of your visit, Excellency?
I would like to have a word with your husband.
He is not here, but perhaps I could be of help.
It concerns a delicate matter. We are looking for a missing cabin boy. According to witnesses,
you seem to have come to the wrong conclusion. The cabin boy you speak of was not taken. He has simply returned home.
Excuse me, but I'm not sure I understand.
Don't you see, Your Excellency? We got our son back.
I am very surprised. Several witnesses confirmed that your son had a fight with your husband, and that his men escorted him from the tavern using force. If he had joined your husband willingly...
Witnesses? In a tavern? And you choose to believe these drunkards over a respectable family?
These witnesses are all in agreement. And it is their testimonies that have led me to your doorstep.
My son was probably shocked to have found us. My husband and the other men might have simply had to carry him. A gesture that your drunkards must have misunderstood.
What was your son doing on a Naut ship? Why would they have taken him?
It is what they do. Through pacts and contracts, they steal away young children from their mothers.
What are you talking about?
I would have thought that a legate would know these things. But it is true that you are young. It is true that you are young and inexperienced. It seems that you have been protected from the turpitudes of our own nation and their terrible allies. This horrible, constant ransoming that they put us through. But I will not say another word. You will have no trouble verifying the details now that you know what to look for.
Where might I find your son now?
I cannot say, Excellency. You must understand why. Until the Nauts have set sail, we live in fear they will take him back from us.
This pact... it sounds like some fear-inducing story.
The Nauts wouldn't be the first to recruit through dubious means.
Now I am curious. I'm very, very curious. So curious, in fact. We're gonna go talk to the Teleme ambassador. And say, hey, fuck you, dude. I'm gonna lose a lot of reputation here.
Lady de Sade, to what do I owe the pleasure?
It pains me to inform you that the heretics you seek have fled.
Curse them! How could that possibly have happened?
Alas, these renegades have found protection with the ambassador of the Bridge Alliance. I would not have been able to capture them without risking a diplomatic incident that my uncle would have condemned.
The Bridge. I thought as much. Those heretics have turned to them. But I had hoped that you might intervene quickly enough to stop them. It is truly regrettable. We have nothing else to do but pray that the Luminous might shield us from their lies.
Nice. Saved it. What's up? Oh my god, I'm actually surprised. That works.
May the light guide you, Desade.
The light's currently blackened upon my own head. Just lied to somebody. Get the fuck out of my way, all of you. Get.
Greetings, Your Excellency.
Dude, I seriously can't wait to leave this place. It's a shithole. I just want to explore a new area. That's gonna be exciting. And more about the
Constantine d'Orsay, future governor of Tir Fredi. I'm enchanted, Captain. I am eager to board your ship.
Enchanted as well, Your Highness. I hope you enjoy your voyage.
Are you ready? Can we weigh anchor?
We should be able to set sail with the tide, as agreed upon. I'm still without news of my cabin, boy. But we will have to do without.
I spoke with a woman who told me she was the mother of the cabin boy. She claims that her son was taken from her.
Taken? Her son is sea gifted. His parents were required to give him up to honor the terms of a contract.
A contract? But what kind of contract are we speaking of?
A commercial contract. In exchange for services rendered by the Nauts, some families cede more than gold. In some cases, nations even trade some of their subjects before they're born. I wouldn't be able to tell you the condition of Jonas's contract. I didn't even know he was originally from Serene. But what I can tell you is the young man hasn't seen his parents since he was a small child. And ever since, he's been a Naut. Our ships are his home, and we are his only family.
Can't leave yet.
Be back soon, Captain.
Still gotta finish up this objective, and then we can go.
Anyone who's not a Naut?
Oh, how I would like my father to be implicated in this sordid business. Our old teacher must surely know what's going on here. Let's go talk to him.
Yes? Well, how can your old...
I've had a word with Lady Fontaine. You must know her. That rich family that lives near the docks. She told me a strange story about her son who was a cabin boy on our ship. She said that he was taken when he was a child due to some contract with the Nauts.
Who was a cabin boy? Do you mean he's no longer one?
They took him back to bring him home.
Well, that is very unpleasant news, Desade. We need to do all we can to bring the boy back to his ship. Since time immemorial, there has always been a certain... price to pay for the services of the Nauts. Children born on their ships belong to them. It's the rule of the sea. But certain contracts are so important that they also require children to be offered in exchange. From time to time, the Congress...